after leaving Duncannon Pier now Tuesday morning, and we're proceeding down the river to Hookhead, where we're going to go approximately 4 to 5 miles off to feed fin whales and hopefully humpback whales.
Well, there's three fin whales just feeding in this immediate area here. You can see the hook a couple of kilometres in the distance there. Martin's picking up quite a lot of fish on the sounder, so it's pretty obvious that there's a lot of fish in this area here. And obviously these three fin whales are moving around this particular area.
We're 5.5 miles southwest of Hookhead, and there's three fin whales together here, working together, where there's a lot of, they're in about 44 metres of water. There's about 10 metres of that of fish. They're working, they're feeding on the fish. So it's easier to keep track of them when three of them are together and get good shots of them, you know, but it's a fantastic sight to see of such a good, fine, clear day. Like, it's nice to see them, you know.
I mean, there's been whales in Irish waters for a long, long time. I mean, whales were commercially harvested off the northwest coast in whaling stations in Mayo and Donegal. That's stopped a long time now, fortunately, and the numbers have took a long time for the numbers to recover. But now, over the last, particularly in the last 5 or 6 years, we're beginning to see fin whales and humpbacks and minkies and harbour porpoises and common dolphins fairly regularly for the larger whales, particularly the January, February kind of post-Christmas period.
The last couple of years is after being an annual thing, and in 2010 there was a fantastic sight of the humpback whale breaching clear out of the water 11 times. In 2011 we've come across another humpback, two humpbacks, and in 2012 we're lucky enough the boat itself to come across another humpback. So all we're waiting for now is 2013 for another one, please God.
Yeah, I was in 2 years ago. I went to Madagascar. I set up for a holiday out there. Madagascar is a place where it's well known for whales. I followed the whales and I love to get photographs. And now when I'm seeing what I can get in my own country, it's unbelievable. I would just something that you would dream about. You have a home here in your own ground, and that's beautiful conditions.
It's great. We've seen three fin whales today. This is our second trip out, and our second trip in total. The first time we saw the humpbacks, and this time's the fin whales. So it's been great to see.
Well, this time of the year now, be quite enough only for the whales. Like, we've been doing chartering all year, like, as regards angling, bringing out anglers and stuff like that, but this time of the year will be quite, so only for that, like, we'll be tied up for the whales, only for the whales. But it brings business to Hookhead and to Duncannon, Ballyhack, Passage East Carferry and Dunmore East and Waterford. People come from near and far to see the whales, like, now that they're here.
Highly recommended. This is my second trip out now. Last one was 2 years ago, where we were lucky enough to see the humpback whales. Unfortunately, no sign of them today.
Well, obviously, we're dealing with a pretty large animal. It's very important that we note that they're protected under the Wildlife Act. But the Department of Marine have also issued a Marine Notice 15 of 2005, giving guidelines for this business where people can come out and see them in a safe manner and that the whales are not disturbed and continue to come back for many, many people to see them over many, many more winters.
A brilliant day today. Plenty of whales, fin whales, and the weather was perfect for it.
We're as high as we go now, so just around over here now is where we saw the last whales, and you can see the race to the south there, you know. The tourism has been great here since the whales turned up around 2009, conveniently in the off-season for tourism, So from about November every year, we get the first reportings, usually of fin whales in the area. And then right up until usually the end of February or March, it's a good time for whale watching. So it brings a lot of people out and it brings a lot of interest, you know, and it lifts the off season, so it's great. The platform is a perfect viewing point to whale watch from, or for all the flora and fauna. In the shoulder seasons, this is a great spot for bird watching as well. Then we have whale season in the off season. So the viewing platform adds a little bit extra. It's there for free use, and it's a nice place because you're not too far away from facilities either. But any headland, but our viewing platform, I think, is the best place to be, yeah.